How do we divide a polynomial with a binomial divisor? That is the concern for this video. I'm going to share to you right now the practice exercise material for the same lesson, division of polynomials. Okay. But instead of having a monomial divisor as presented in our previous video, we are now presented with a binomial divisor. Okay. So you might say, I would just simply, sir, use the same process as last time. And that's why I will have here x squared for number one, 13x plus 30 divided by x plus 3. I change it to a rational expression. And then I have here, I could just simply distribute the denominator or share it to all the terms, x plus 3. Then you have here plus 13x over x plus 3. And finally, you would say I have 30 over x plus 3. However, if you will reach this specific expression, you can actually use cancellation law. And then you say, I will divide this, sir. I will divide 30 by 3. I will remove x here. Because there is a presence of a process of addition or even later on subtraction in your denominator. If the terms in your numerator and denominator are separated by either subtraction or addition, cancellation law cannot be used, because again, the complete name for cancellation law is cancellation law for multiplication. In short, what we did before in the previous video when we deal with monomial divisors cannot be used here. There are also other processes that you are more familiar, that some of you might be familiar with. You may use the concept of factoring, factoring. You are going to look for the factors of the numerator and then later on cancel it with x plus 3. If you're advanced with those concepts, you may actually use them if you want. But there, if for some of us, and for if not most, for some of us who are not yet familiar with how this factoring works, I'm going to present to you the simplest, not necessarily the simplest, but the basic processes to divide polynomial with a binomial divisor. And I'm going to use here the concept of long division. Long division is not new to all of us. Long division is actually used in your elementary years. Long division is actually the process that you did when you're trying to divide 143 by 11. To divide 143 by 11, your elementary years, you use this process. This is the divisions. This is the division. A symbol for division here, and you're placing here 143 inside, and you're placing 11 outside. And then when you divide this one, you are actually using many processes. Number one, you divide 14 by 11. So the first step is division. Okay, 14 divided by 11, we only have 1, because we will have a remainder. Okay, and then that's the first quotient. And then you return 1 times 11, you will have 11. Next process is you subtract. 14 minus 11 is actually 3. And since you still have one more digit here, you bring it down. And then you repeat the process as what you did earlier. 33 divided by 11 is a 3. And 3 times 11 is 33. And then you subtract. The answer is 0. By the way, I would like to correct one important thing. Okay. This may not be noticed, may have not been noticed in your elementary years, but I'm going to correct it. In your elementary years, you used on using x as a determinant that the quotient is 0. I mean, the remainder, not necessarily quotient, the remainder is 0. You're saying that here, 30 minus 33, we have the difference is 0, so you use x. But of course, I'm trying to explain this one, that you cannot use this symbol anymore here. Because if you will say that 33 minus 33 is equal to x, x is a variable already in algebra, and x can take any values. It can take 0, yes, But it can take negative 1, it can take 1, even fractions, and even irrational numbers. Therefore, if the result is just simply 0, do not use x. As for this level, use simply 0. By the way, I'm just explaining this for the long division process first before we will apply it in the given problem. So this is 0, and this is now the number value here at the top. This is your quotient. To check whether your quotient is correct or not, we are going to multiply your quotient to your divisor, and it should return to the dividend. 13 times 11 is 143. It returned to the original dividend. Therefore, 13 as a quotient is the correct answer. This is actually the long division you did in your elementary years. Why am I presenting this? It's because we are going to use the same concept when we solve here. Again, for those of you who are familiar with factoring, please bear with us. We are going to use the basic processes of long division for us, for majority of us, to learn it first before we go with factoring. So in short, we are going to use this symbol here, division symbol. I have already placed this symbol here at the bottom. I'm just going to copy this one, pardon. I'm going to copy this probably here for number 2 later. I'm going to move this up. Okay, so this is the division, the symbol for division for this process, for the long division. 143 here is actually your dividend. In short, for this given problem in number 1, the dividend is x squared plus 13x plus 30. So that is what you're going to place inside this symbol. X squared plus 13x plus 30. Okay. Yeah. And then 11 in the given, in the previous problem, in the simplest form of long division, is the divisor. You place it outside. Let us also place here the divisor, x plus 3 outside. But there is one important thing you need to do, that your divisor must be in the form of a group. Okay, because if you're not going to place parenthesis here, this one, if you're just going to use this, this might be interpreted that you are dividing x squared plus 13x plus 30 with 3 only. It doesn't include the first term x. Okay, so to make it more clearer that it should be x plus 3, you place here the parentheses. So this is the copy of the first of the long division that you are doing in your elementary years. And then we're just going to copy the same processes in the what happened to 143 divided by 11. The first step earlier was to divide 14 by 11. Supposedly, we could actually divide automatically 143 by 11. But since we are doing it step by step, we only chose 14 because 14 is the first few digits that can be divided by 11. Copying the same process, we are just going to use here x squared and an x. That's the first process. Only divide the first term to the first term. So that's the first process here, division. Divide the first terms. That's the first process. Divide the first terms. That's letter D. So when we divide first term, you have x squared divide by x. Use the law, division law of exponents, and then you have x 2 minus 1, which will result to x to the power 1 or x. This is your first quotient. Look at what happened earlier. 14 divided by 11, your first quotient is 1. You place it at the top. So this is our first quotient for number 1 here. So x must be placed here at the top. Okay. Next step. In your elementary division of 143 by 11, the second step after you got 1 is you multiplied 1 by 11. 1 times 11, you have here 11 here. So we are going to use the same process, multiply the first quotient to the divisor. But when you're going to multiply the first quotient to the divisor, it should be the whole divisor, not just in x, not just in 3, but more of both. Looking back here, sorry, if I'm going to skip from one example to another, because we're using the same process here. Here, we multiplied 1 by the digit of 1, so you get 1. And then you also multiplied 1 by the tens digit of 1, or 10. That's why you have here 10 plus 1, 11. Similar here, multiply the first quotient to x, and also multiply the first quotient to the second term of the divisor. Therefore, the second step is multiplication. And that's why you have x, let's use colon, okay, just to separate, x times x plus 3, and you will use here the division, a distributive property rather, x times x, x times 3. So you will have your x times x is x squared, and then you have x times 3, you have here plus 3x. Similar to what happened here in 11, you place it under 14. You also need to place this first product here, and you will have your x squared plus 3x. That's the second step. The third step is, of course, what happened as the third step here. You subtracted 14 and 11. So 14 minus 11, you have here your difference. So same thing here, we are going to subtract. But wait, when we are going to subtract for this process here, we are subtracting the whole first product. So do not forget that they actually belong to a same group. We have here the grouping symbol. The purpose for this grouping symbol is to emphasize that when we are going to subtract this first product, we are not just subtracting x squared, but we are also subtracting 3x here. This grouping symbol might be may be represented, okay, this is our third step, with this x squared plus 13x, this is the terms at the top, minus x squared plus 3x. In treating these two terms as a group, you are treating here this sign to be distributed to both here. Because if you will not treat this as a group, you're only saying that the x squared will have the negative or the minus sign, but 3x will still remain as plus. So it should be distributed, and as therefore, it will return to x squared plus 13x. You have negative times positive 1 here, that's the numerical coefficient. You have negative x squared, and then negative times positive will also be negative 3x. Take a look at this. This is in considering that this is a group. But if you are not going to consider that as a group, and let's say you did not place any parentheses there, look at the difference. You still have minus x squared, but what happens to 3x? Here it's plus, here it's minus. Because in the first example, without the grouping symbol, you're treating the minus sign to x squared only. But it should be this way. That is why meron talagang ano. It should have a parenthesis, and the sign might be distributed. And of course, simplify. X squared minus x squared here will be 0, because that's 1 minus 1. And 13 minus 3 is 10x. This 10x is now your first difference here. 10x. Okay, similar to what happened here, 14 minus 11, you have 3. The next step is you bring down the remaining digit. Same here. We are going to bring down the remaining term. But when we are going to bring it down, do not write here 30. Okay. It should be a term. They are separate terms. Think of the separator plus. So instead of writing 30, we may move this a little bit here. There should be the sign or separator addition. Okay. Now that we have this term here, we need to repeat same as what happened in our previous example. 33 can still be divided by 11. So we repeat the same processes. We divide, we multiply, we subtract. And if there are other terms that can be brought down, you need to bring it down and return until everything will be exhausted. But in this case, 10x will be divided to x. So this is our second quotient, 10x over x, which could actually be removed by cancellation law. And therefore, your answer is 10. Since 10 is the second quotient, it should be separated by the first quotient. Do not write x10. It should not be x10. They are two different quotients. X is the first quotient. 10 is the second quotient. So how do we separate it? We look at the sign of the second quotient. The sign of the second quotient is plus, is positive 10. Therefore, it should not be x10. It should be separated by a positive or plus sign, and you have here 10. Sir, what if the result here, just what if the result here is negative 10? So the negative will be the separator here, and instead of using plus, you are going to use here minus, because that is actually the sign here. But since the resulting earlier is positive, so we retain positive 10. This is now the separator of the first and the second quotients. Please be careful with that. So we are done with the second quotient. The next is multiplication. Again, when you multiply, it should take the sign here as a term, multiply it to x, multiply it to 3. So you have here this second product. You have positive 10 times x plus 3. Distribute that. 10 times x is 10x. 10 times 3 is 30, positive 30. So you will have here 10x plus 30. Next step, subtract. But take note, it should be subtract as a whole. And when you subtract as a whole, your second difference, you will have this expression here. I'm going to write it here. So 10x plus 30 minus the whole quantity of 10x plus 30. Using breaking of the grouping symbol, proceed by negative sign, distribute. And then you will have here 10x plus 30. The 10x here, the positive will become minus 10x. And the positive 30 will become minus 30. So you have 10x minus 10x is 0. 30 minus 30 is also 0. So the result is 0. The difference here is 0, not x. Again, do not use x here because it may mean something. Use 0, which means nothing. Now that we have here a 0 and no other terms can be brought down, we are now sure that there is no remainder. Same here, no remainder. And what is found at the top? In this case, this expression, x plus 10 is your quotient. This is the result when we are going to divide x squared plus 13x plus 30 by x plus 3. How do we know if the quotient x plus 10 is the correct quotient? Again, same here. How did we know that 13 is the correct quotient when 143 is divided by 11? We multiplied the quotient and the divisor. So 13 times 11 becomes 143. We return to the original dividend, and therefore we are now sure that 13 is the correct quotient. So to determine whether x plus 10 is the correct quotient, multiply it. This is just the checking, which is actually optional. So x plus 10 as your divisor, the quotient, must be multiplied to your divisor x plus 3. Multiplication of two binomials will probably use a FOIL method. So you will have FOIL, f times f, x times x is x squared. And then you will have here outer, x times 3 is positive 3x. Inner, 10 times x is positive 10x. And then you have your last, 10 times 3 is 30. The second and the third terms can still be combined. And that's why you will have your x squared. 3 plus 10 is 13x plus 30. Look at the product when we multiply our quotient with our divisor, and look at the original dividend. Since they are the same, x squared plus 13x plus 30, we are now sure, very sure, that the quotient when x squared plus 13x plus 30 is divided by x plus 3 is x plus 10. Again, checking is optional, but it will be better if you will check it. This is how we multiply any polynomial with a binomial divisor. We are using here the long division process. So let's just use the same process for number 2. Copying the method, we are going to place here the dividend, 2x squared plus x minus 6. Be careful with the signs. And you have here your quotient, divisor x plus 2. To do that, first quotient is the first term and first term, 2x squared over x. 2 divided by 2 is just 2. And you have x, 2 minus 1. So that's 2x to the power of 1, or simply 2x. 2x is your first quotient, place it here. Next step is to multiply. Multiply as a whole, to the whole. So your second step, you have here 2x times x plus 2. Using the distributive property, so you have 2 times 1 is 2, and then your x 1 plus 1 for the first term. And use plus a separator, 2 times 2 is 4, and you have here x. Next, you have here 2x squared plus 4x. This is your first product. You place it here at the bottom. 2x squared plus 4x. That's the second step. Let me just extend here this material so that we could actually write or place more computations. Next is to subtract. But it should be taken as a whole. Do not forget to take it as a whole, because if you will not, definitely your quotient later on may be incorrect. The subtraction process, you have 2x squared plus x here minus the whole quantity 2x squared plus 4x. Distribute the sign here, and then you will have 2x squared plus x, negative times positive is negative 2, x squared, negative times positive is negative 4x. So 2x squared minus 2x squared will become 0. And here's the tricky thing, 1 minus 4. 1 minus 4 is negative 3x. Sorry. And that is actually your first difference, negative 3x. Why I said it's tricky? Look at what are your expressions here. You have positive x, positive 4x, but the difference is negative 3x. Why? Because again, you treated this as a whole, and the plus sign here actually became subtraction when you distribute the negative sign. That's why it's negative 3x. Next is to bring down the remaining term as minus 6, and we repeat the processes. First, let's just do this. Next is division. Division, first term. So you have here negative 3x over x. Simply cancel x, and you will have here the result, negative 3. Since, again, this is second quotient, it should be differentiated with the first term as the first quotient. So you have minus 3. So use this minus as a separator, and you have minus 3. To multiply as the next process, do not just take 3. Do not just take 3, but 3 here carries the sign of the negative here as you distribute that one. Because again, when we determined coefficients before, the operation before becomes its sign. Earlier, the operation was plus 10, so it was positive 10. Now it's minus 3, so it should be negative 3. So your second product would be negative 3, negative 3 times x plus 2. Distribute that here. So you have negative 3x and negative times positive times negative 3 times positive 2 becomes minus 6. Place it here, negative 3x minus 6. Next step, subtract, but again as a whole. Because when you subtract it, you'll have here negative 3x minus 6 minus the whole quantity of negative 3x minus 6. When you distribute here, then minus sign, double negative property, again, double negative property. So this will become negative 3x minus 6. Negative times negative will become plus 3x. Negative times negative will become plus 6. Negative 3x plus 3 is 0. Negative 6 plus 6 is also 0. So the result here is 0. The main second difference is 0. Again, let's use x. No more other terms that can be divided. So what appears at the top, which is 2x minus 3, is your answer. So that's 2x minus 3. I'm just going to leave checking with you. Determine whether this is really our correct quotient by multiplying this with our divisor, and it should return to the given dividend. So this is how long division of polynomials work for binomial divisor. By the way, you can also use long division for monomial divisor, but what we have presented in the previous video is the simplest process. So you may use that. You may use long division if you want. You need to practice this, because this practice exercise actually uses the four operations of polynomials. As you can see, we divided, we multiplied. When we subtract using the grouping symbol, later on we also added terms. So in just one problem, you have summarized all operations of polynomials. We still have another video for division of polynomials, so stay tuned. Goodbye.